Hi, today I want to show you a cool effect you can create with PowerPoint. This is the effect. Isn't it beautiful? You can do this with your own photo. In fact, why don't you try it right now? Pull out the best sunglasses you have, take a selfie, transfer the picture onto your PowerPoint, and then follow this tutorial to create this nice effect. The best part is, once you create this effect, you can save this as an animated GIF, and you can send it to anyone you want, sticking the image right inside your mail. So there is a whole bunch of creative stuff you can do with this idea. So let us jump right in and learn how to create this beautiful effect from scratch. But before that, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com, the creator of Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program, a comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training program for professionals. This effect is surprisingly easy. First step is to insert your picture. I'm just going to use a stock photo. So let us go to Insert, Pictures, and Stock Images. I'm going to search for sunglasses and hit Enter. There are quite a few very interesting options available here. I want to pick something that looks really nice, where there is a clear front-on image of the coolers. You can use something like this or maybe something like this. Let me pick this one up and say Insert. And then you can extend this to the entire page. So you need to go to Crop, which is in the Home tab. Go to Picture Format, Crop, and say Aspect Ratio, and change the aspect ratio to 16:9, and that crops the image exactly as per the slide dimension. Then click outside and then align this to the top left corner of the slide. Click and drag from the corner. Now your picture extends to the entire slide. The next step is to cut out these two portions which represent the glasses. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From Lines, you can pick up this one called as the Curve tool. You need to really zoom in quite nicely so you're able to have enough amount of space available for you to work with this curve tool. Let me click on the first spot here and then extend this slightly and then click again. So you can just follow the contours of this shape. You don't really have to be too precise with it. You can always adjust these curvatures a bit later. So I'm just going to go with the rough outline of this sunshades. At any point, if you want to manipulate any of the points here, you just need to right click and go to Edit Points, and you can always adjust any of these points. You can click on it and you can have these handles to work with. Everything is totally in your control. The next step is to do it for this side. So once again, let me go to the same curve tool and then draw for this side. I don't really want any outline for these two shapes, so I'm going to select both of them and say Shape Outline, No Outline. And then click on this tool which says Fit Slide to Current Window, and that takes it back to the original size of the slide. Then you select the picture first and then hold the Shift button down and select these two shapes that you drew just now. And then go to Shape Format, Merge Shapes, and say Shape Subtract. That's it. You punched two holes in the place where the glasses existed before. Now we are going to place a video behind this to create the magic. Let me go to pixabay.com and you can search for hearts and you will find this video. You just need to change this to videos and then you will be able to get this option here. You can download this. I've already downloaded this here. So let me right click, copy, and then come back to my slide. Right click and paste it. Now I have my picture pasted. I can send this behind. So right click and send this to back. And the most important point here is you go to playback option while the video is selected and then go to start automatically and say loop until stopped. And these two are important parameters to check. And once it is done, you can go to slideshow and you can see this beautiful effect. Once you created the effect, all you need to do is to export this as an animated GIF. For that, let me go to File, Export, and say Create an Animated GIF. You don't really have to worry too much about any of these parameters. You can just say Create GIF. I'm going to keep the size as medium. You can, of course, change this to low if you want to send this by email. Let me say Create GIF, and you can choose the place where you want to keep it. Let me call this Nice Coolers, and I'm going to save this in the desktop and say Save. You can see that the GIF is getting created. You then create your mail, you copy the image, and then go to the body of your email and say right click and paste, and that would paste the GIF that you have just saved, and then you say send. When you open the mail, initially you may not actually see the image. It takes a couple of seconds for it to load, and once it loads, it really looks beautiful and you will definitely get a response for this email. Of course, you can customize this the way you want by writing your text using your text box tool and send personal messages. You can totally customize this the way you want. If you have not already signed up for our 25 Creative PowerPoint Ideas free email course, then do yourself a favor and join this free email course right away. These are 25 useful, practical, and simple ideas that I don't share elsewhere. The link is in the description box below the video, or you can find the link right here on the right hand side. So click, join the course, and take your PowerPoint slides to the next level.